For years, I've been using NordVPN to secure my internet connection, to tunnel past internet censorship in China, and to bypass Netflix geo-blocking while living abroad. Over the past few years since my last NordVPN review, they have exploded in popularity, and they've spent literally millions of dollars on a marketing blitz that has put all of their VPNs to shame. So they've paid a bunch of influencers a lot of money to say great things about their service. Big deal. But is NordVPN really that good? That's what we're here to find out. Welcome to another video from All Things Secured. My name's Josh, and my goal is to provide a clear review of NordVPN based on my years of using their service and try to make it as unbiased as possible. Over the next few minutes, I'm going to show you the desktop and mobile software. I'm going to explain a lot of the features that they offer, compare them against other VPNs on the market, and finally share with you my concerns. Let's start by moving over to my computer here to explore the NordVPN desktop app. One of the first things you'll notice when you open up the NordVPN software is this huge map that they have. It makes it really easy actually to understand what you're doing. You're connecting to a server in a different country and you can scroll the map and choose exactly where you want to connect. So if I want to connect to the United States, I just click that country and it's going to connect to the fastest available server in that country. And there are multiple servers in every single country. So as you can see here on the left side, I've got a list of all the different countries that are available. And if I can even go in and look at the different servers within that country that I could choose from. In most cases, that doesn't make sense, except for, let's say, in the United States, where I can choose a specific city that I want to connect to if that's something that's important to you. Now, depending on the type of connection, the type of protocol, you're going to have a number of specialty servers that you can choose from. You can do double VPN, which is something that allows you to do two VPNs at once. I'll explain that a little more later. Obfuscated servers, which are basically servers that make your internet traffic on a VPN look like it's just normal traffic. In those cases where maybe you've got a government or you've got a company that's trying to minimize the use of VPNs. You have Onion over VPN. There's a couple different options there, as well as peer-to-peer servers, and they've got a number of those that you can choose from. Now, like I said, those change based on what kind of protocol that you're connecting to. And the preferences that they have here are not that robust. We can auto launch, we can choose to use their CyberSec technology, which I'll explain in a little bit, to block ads and malware. And then of course we've got these VPN protocols. I would recommend at least OpenVPN, but they do have this new NordLynx, which uses the WireGuard system, and that's something that they're touting a lot now. And again, that's something I'll explain here in a little bit more. You can choose to help them improve. I tend to keep that off. But now it's just, you can choose trusted networks, the specific appearance. They're obviously going to tell you all of their different apps that you can choose from as well. And then, of course, my account information. What you're going to notice absent here is any ability to turn off a VPN kill switch. It is on the app and it's automatic and it's always on, but you can't turn it off. That's something that maybe you might find frustrating, but actually it's really a good thing for you. You want to have that kill switch on at all times. But other than that, it's a pretty basic, a pretty easy to understand software that anybody could use. Great. Now I'm going to pull out my iPad to give you a look at the mobile application. As you can see here, the user interface for NordVPN's mobile app is very intuitive. You can zoom in, you can choose a specific country, you can choose a server in that country, or quick connect to the fastest one in that country. If you're looking at the United States, you can look at all the different cities that you could choose from, or again, quick connect to the fastest server, or you can ask NordVPN to find the very fastest server available and connect to it, and you can see this green bar here indicates that I am connected to a VPN in addition to the VPN notification here. Now, on the left side here, you can see I've got all the different countries that I can choose from if I wanted to go that direction. I've got favorites, and then, of course, we were talking about the specialty servers. In this case right now, with the protocol that I'm using, I only have access to P2P, peer-to-peer servers. But let's say if I want to go up here in the top right and look at my settings, I can change my protocol from NordLynx to, let's say, OpenVPN. And when I do that, you're going to see that my specialty servers, now I have the ability to choose a dedicated IP, a double VPN, the obfuscated servers, Onion over VPN, and P2P. So make sure as you're using the mobile app that you realize that this choice of a VPN protocol is extremely important. You've got the OpenVPN has been the standard for most of the time, but you can also choose this new NordLynx, which uses the WireGuard protocol. So that's what you have here on the side. You can favorite, you can use recent connections as well. As far as the settings are concerned, you also have the ability to turn on CyberSec, which I'll again describe in a moment. VPN protocol, which we already talked about. You can auto connect based on Wi-Fi networks or just always auto connect whenever you're on. And then you can reset your VPN profile. There's not too much else. You can help them improve by sending data anonymously. I always tend to not want to do that, like I said before. And then once you're connected to a VPN server, I tend to just keep the close out the app and let it work in the background. In my opinion, NordVPN continues to offer one of the best pieces of VPN software on the market. It's easy to install and incredibly user-friendly, even for those of you who may not be tech savvy. But design only takes you so far. So let's dive into the various features that NordVPN offers. As with any review that I do here on All Things Secured, I want to differentiate between those standard features and those that are unique to the service itself. Marketing copy can make military-grade encryption sound like an amazing feature, but the reality is that it's standard across the industry, and so I don't want to praise them for it. These features include, at least at the time of this recording, AES 256-bit encryption, over 5,500 servers spread across 59 countries, a zero log policy, a VPN kill switch, email and live chat customer support, dedicated apps for all the major platforms, and a 30-day money-back guarantee. Now, mind you, none of the features on this list are particularly special. This is what you should expect with any VPN that you're looking at right now. So what NordVPN features are unique? We'll start with simultaneous connections. NordVPN offers 6 simultaneous connections, which means that you can have 6 different devices connected to their servers at the same time. The industry standard is between 3 and 5, so NordVPN comes out on top here. Double VPN. For those of you who want an added layer of security, NordVPN offers you the ability to connect to 2 VPN servers, changing your IP address twice. Now, this is something that a few other VPNs offer, such as Surfshark that I've reviewed before, but it's not very common at all. NordVPN gives you P2P and Onion over VPN servers, which, if those terms don't really make much sense to you, it's probably not going to be a feature that benefits you. But if you do, then you'll understand why that's valuable. CyberSec, which is a combination ad blocker and malicious site blocker that gives you just another added layer of security as you browse the internet. And finally, NordLinks, which is just a fancy name for NordVPN's implementation of WireGuard. Now, this is a protocol that's still under development, but it's touted as one of the fastest and most secure VPN protocols on the market today. These are the features that make NordVPN unique, but how do they stack up against competitors like ExpressVPN, Surfshark, IPVanish, and others? The truth, despite all the marketing you're going to see on the internet, is that there's really not that much that differentiates the top VPN providers. They all claim to have military-grade encryption, they all claim to have zero-log policies, and they all have thousands of servers spread across the globe. Honestly, despite a few minor features here or there, it really just boils down to pricing, user experience, and trust. And NordVPN tends to be highly rated across the internet because it's done very well balancing both pricing and user experience. I mean, you saw the apps earlier in this video, they're excellent. The only concern worth pointing out here is that issue of trust. The reason for this is twofold. First, it's not entirely clear who owns and runs NordVPN. I mean, we know it's based in Panama and owned by a company called Tefincom SA, but that's really about all we know. Now, this is a little bit of a red flag for me personally, since basically what we're doing is we're securing our data by routing it through the servers of an unknown entity. Now, to be fair, this same accusation can be leveled against most popular VPN services. With few exceptions, such as ViperVPN or IPVanish, VPN companies tend to be extremely vague about their ownership. The second concern regarding trust has to do with a breach that happened on a server NordVPN was leasing back in 2018. And as you can imagine, a security company being hacked garnered a lot of press. Based on my research, you might find it ironic that this security breach doesn't concern me quite as much as the opaque ownership. You see, the breach itself did not compromise any user privacy, and in the end, it resulted in a number of internal and external audits on the NordVPN servers that have probably made the NordVPN network probably one of the most reliably secure available today. As of this recording, they offer a bug bounty reward to maintain that high level of security, which is something I don't see other VPNs doing. So what's my final verdict on NordVPN? Well, it's an amazing piece of software that ticks all of the boxes of the features that you expect to have with a VPN. As far as security is concerned, NordVPN is probably ahead of its competition in the way that it's adopted new protocols like WireGuard, as well as how it's gone about auditing its server network and security protocols. My only concern here, and it's the same one that I have for most of the top VPNs, is that I have no idea who owns and runs the company, and there's just no level of accountability there. When it comes to your data security and online and privacy, the truth is that you're really stuck between the devil you know versus the one that you don't. As for me, I use NordVPN on my desktop and mobile device, but you'll have to make that decision for yourself whom you trust with your data. If this review of NordVPN has been useful to you, why don't you take that easy step of clicking the like button or using the affiliate links in the description. I'll do my best to answer any question you have in the comments, and don't forget to subscribe to the All Things Secured YouTube channel, where I'll have more great reviews like this and tips for online security.